iPadOS 16 brings us the ability to customise the toolbars in our apps. So for example, in this app, Keynote, I can customise the buttons at the top of my screen to make my commonly used ones easily accessible. Here I've got some pictures of some big cats, and I want to remove the background from all of them. Of course, I can simply press the paintbrush and then remove background, but I can actually save a tap here by customising my toolbar. So I'll press the three dots in the top right hand corner, and then go down to Customise Toolbar. From here, you can actually see there's about 30 or so different icons that you can add to your toolbar. Now, depending on the project you're working on or your workflow in general, some will be a lot more useful to you than others. For me, I'm going to drag and drop the Remove Background button from there onto my toolbar. Now, you can only put these in the middle section of your toolbar on the right-hand side. If I move it to the left-hand side, it won't let me drop it there. But on the right-hand side, I can let go, and that's added it to the toolbar for me. I'll do the same with the Move to Front and Move to Back buttons, and put them at the top too. Then, when I save that toolbar, those buttons are there now for me at the top of that screen, and they'll be there for any document I open in Keynote. Of course, I can simply tap on them to use them just like you would expect, and if I wanted to change them or get rid of them, I can press the three dots and customise toolbar again. From here, I can drag and drop them off the toolbar and back into that tool palette, or I can press reset to wipe the whole toolbar back to its normal state. I hope you found this tip helpful, and maybe you've learned something new. If you have, please do give it a like, or even subscribe down below. I'm making loads of iPad quick tip videos to help you make the most of that very important device that you own, and I'd love you to be part of my journey with me. I'll see you in the next video.